struggle. I don't like to fight.
What?
But I ain't scared to bleed.
Okay, yeah.
Most don't mess with a guy like me.
That's probably the baddest girl, not mine. I'm not a You're creepy.
You're angry. Leading off the top of the second, the pitcher, number 22, Cesar Cantu.
I'll try my best. I'm sorry, Rochelle. I'm sorry to let you down. It wasn't on purpose. It wasn't intentional. You're a gremlin. You're my gremlin.
Number 13, designated hitter, Kaysen Crane.
Oh, okay. I get it. Ooh, I'm going too low. My bad. You never heard that? Yeah, sink it, Raquel. Sink it, Raquel. You got this. Where the ball at? Oh, she got it. She got it. It's in the bag. Oh, that's what I was doing. Let's see how I just did that. That was smooth. Yes, me. She's insane. In the membrane. It's staying in the brain.
Number 11, first baseman, okay, Sean Condal.
Yep. Just like your mom. I am. Legal. Where'd it go? It's gone. Did I just undo my focus? Is that good? All right. Sorry, I think I'm smacking again. I think I got that.
Number one, second baseman, Bobby Barrow.
Thank you, thank you. I'll be bowing, but I really can't. Why would I do that? Yeah. You always assume the worst of me, bro. Exactly. You always assume so bad of me. Yeah, but then, like, Raquel was saying otherwise. She just wants me to get on my knees for her. I'm just kidding. I will.
Go, baby!
Throwing that out. Yeah?
Number five, catcher Ryder Robinson.
Addiction with aliens. Who is that? Oh, okay, I thought so. This wasn't sure. Oh, okay, sorry. Dang, I'm sorry. Oh my gosh. I just wasn't sure. I'm sorry, Eris.
I'm so sorry. Smart one.
I truly am. No, I truly am. I'm sorry. I mean it. Kind of or was? I'm just kidding. I was waiting for y'all to say that, bro. They're really living out Earth. Broski. That was so bad. No, like, their bat was, like, them. That was... Yeah. Exactly. Not me, them. No, because she thought I was talking about me. She thought I was saying I was bad. Oh. Also, a little slow. I don't know what you're thinking. She's on something.
Thank you.
say it like that.
Senior left fielder Brayden Malone.
Well, I know, but I can't see it on the left, so I'm looking on the right. Maybe it was different for me. I don't know. What? Well, yeah, I know that. I was thinking of that we set up one. Oh, F1 up here. I wasn't talking about those buttons. Anymore. Now who doesn't know the left and the right? Now who doesn't know the left and the right? You should apologize to me.
Number 22, senior third baseman, Caden Johnson.
Bro, what? It doesn't make sense. It's crazy. She is a loss. Who says that, bro? Why did she say that? Why'd I repeat it? That is crazy. Huh? Reese's Puffs. It's eat it up. Yeah, you're best. Yeah. Okay, that's enough. I don't want to sing peaches to you. That's not simple. Yours is way longer than mine. Yes, it is. Mine's like a minute. Yours is like a minute.
Working on the weekend like yours
were two. Senior, it's your deep end like yours Norman.
Swear they passed us. They doing too much.
Haven't well, you done my taxes. I'm too turned up. Thing. I gave you the
Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts. Caught me slipping once,
like,
okay, so what? Someone hit your block, but
I
tell you if it was us. Man, a house in Rosewood,
I'll do, the Goofy song. What's the Goofy? What's the hot dog, hot diggity dog? You're crazy. That's insane. That's too much. That was back, no? For water. Who's pitching? 22. Why'd you see a 9? That's a 2. Well, that's why I said 22 and she still said 29. I think she heard me. She was trying to argue with me. For real, right? She wants to yell. She just wants to fight with someone. It's okay. I'll let you fight with me. 2. Yeah, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what 2 is. Ooh.
number 7, junior second baseman Paxton Graves.
I'd love to hear you yap. What'd I do? Me? Wait, that was good? Wait, what do you mean? Is it good like that? Okay. Oh my god, what is your obsession with aliens? They call you an alien? Sure. Do they call each other aliens? Bruh. Alright, who was that? Okay, Brother Raquel. That's insane. After yelling at us about it, it's crazy. I'm such a hypocrite.
Hey, let's go finish it right
here.
You're
being hypocritical right now. Because why are you being a hypocrite? Oh, okay. Eileen. She ratted you out. She asked in the headset. Like, did you not hear it? Wait, why am I still on air? Okay, whatever you say. That's insane. I cannot zone out Raquel. Never mind, I'm not saying that. That sounds a little creepy. Why'd it go silent? I was gonna say, like, hearing her voice. Where'd that go? Oh, that's like over there.
No.
Oh, I can't get that. Okay, whatever. Emily likes to argue. She's just like Raquel. No, you're just like Raquel. You can't see Raquel just like me because she's older. And I was fixing you. What? Whoa! Too much. Too far. You went too far. If you're going too far, you're going way too far. Don't call me that. That's not me. That is not me. Don't agree. Stop. Okay, thank you.
Number 13, sophomore pinch hitter Landon Dunham.
Oh. gonna walk away. Raquel's gonna yell at me tomorrow in physics if I do that. Tomorrow in physics. Asking you. That's so true though. Emily's always so rude. You're so rude. She's so rude. Especially in Mr. G's class. She loves to bully me. She starts the argument. She's the one that starts it. You see? I wasn't even arguing.
Number 30, senior catcher Brady Gray.
I wouldn't be the first thing in today if it wasn't for my sister. What just happened? I don't know what just happened. Are you? Do I fix it? I don't like this. I can't see anything. I can't see that. Hey, I can't see. I can't see it. Why did you do this? Fix it, please. I can't see anything like this, bro. I can fix it. Bro. It went right back. I'm just gonna... I don't like this. It keeps going back. It keeps going back. Oh my gosh, what is this thing, bro? Emma, is that you? Are you smacking?
Dugout brings the count 1-2 strikes. Catcher tried to bring that back in the zone, but that was about 12 inches outside. 2-2, evens the count on Gray. If you're superstitious or a betting person, counts 2-2, 2 outs, bottom of the second. Make a wish. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Brady's going to line that one just over second base. That's definitely going to score two. Throw to home moves Brady up to second base. Good call by Rogers.
They are. Number one, senior.
Great job by Brady to get that at bat. Caddo is going to take a timeout here. Coach is going to come out and talk to his infield. We'll be back after these brief moments. Station identification. Welcome back here in the bottom of the second. Quick timeout by Caddo. First pitch to Fuller. Ball low for ball one. If you're just tuning in to us, Brady Gary hit a two-run single to right center. Try to make a throw at home and then moved him up to second base. That's going to be down for another two runs. There's a two-run double we were wanting just a second ago. Great job to answer back by the Farmers. Two hits, four runs. Farmers back on top, 4-3 here in the bottom of the second.
Number five, senior DH.
Next up for the Farmers, number five, the DH, Colin Berry. Guys definitely have stepped up this season in regards to filling the spot that Colin Berry has missed in the lineup, shoulder injury. Man, the way they've stepped up and filled that spot has just been a great testament to this team. First pitch misses outside for ball one to Berry. Chopper hit to the second base side. Easy play for out number three, but not before your Farmers come back and get four runs and a great scoring opportunity there in the bottom of the second to regain the lead, 4-3. We'll be back here in just a moment for the top of the third. We are back here at Farmer Stadium for the top of the third. Great job by the Farmers in the bottom of the second to offensively take charge and get those runs back as they took the lead 4-3 on a couple base hits by Jordan Fuller and Brady Gray to get four RBIs between the two of them. Luke Douglas leading off for the Foxes as that ball apparently is just outside for ball one. Douglas had a three-run charge, home run in the first. That's going to be how the Caddo Foxes got their first three runs. That pitch there was called a strike. Looked worse than the first pitch. It was called a ball. That ball catches the outside breaking pitch. One ball, two strikes. Norman's got a sign. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Breaking pitch misses just outside, evens the count, two balls, two strikes. Like I said earlier, this is a big game for the Farmers. Doesn't really matter for the Foxes. They're 1-6 in district. Hit hard to the third base side to KJ. Throw across the diamond. Scoop by Irwin at first for out number one. Great defensive play right there by the corners. Douglas, one of their hottest bats on the team.
Number eight, third baseman, Colin McIntosh.
Correct me if I'm wrong, if somebody knows better, but I believe I heard that he is hitting over 600 in district. Next up, third baseman Talon McIntosh. His first time up, had a single past the shortstop. First pitch there, swing and a miss. Sky to the right side, foul territory. Plenty of room for Irwin. He's going to make the play for a quick out number two. Next up for the Fox is number four, Tyler Wilson, the shortstop. He hit into a double play his first time up this evening in the first inning. First pitch in there catches the outside corner for strike one. Inside low for ball one. Evens account. One ball, one strike.
Oh, my God. They look crazy. They look blown up. You put them in the microwave. They were radioactive. Your voice is correct.
Up and away just outside. Two balls, one strike. Here's a 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, evens account, two balls, two strikes on Wilson.
Wait, are you live? So it turns red when you're live. That's so cool. No, like, what?
Norman shakes off a pitch, gets the one he likes, comes set. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Wilson throws his bat at it, fouls it off over the screen. Still two balls, two strikes. On Wilson, here's a 2-2 pitch. Skies at to center field. Venegas is calling him off. Camps underneath for out number three. So a quick three up, three down inning, exactly what the Farmers needed here in the top of the third. We'll be back here in just a moment for the offensive side of the bottom third. We're back here in the bottom of the third as your Farmers got three up, three down in the top of the second against the Foxes. Leading off for the Farmers, number 14, Mason Irwin. Popped up to shortstop his first time up this evening. Cantu still on the mound for the Foxes. Only at 40 pitches through two and a half. Just a bit outside for ball one. Right through the hands of the first base coach, Peyton Rogers. We're going to count that an E coach on the right side. Foul ball evens account, one ball, one strike on Irwin. Cantu from the windup gets his sign. Here's a 1-1 pitch. Low in the dirt, two balls, one strike. Two balls, one strike to Irwin. Cantu delivers a pitch. Outside, three balls, one strike. Here's a 3-1 pitch from Cantu. Outside, ball four for a leadoff walk. Puts a base runner on for the Farmers.
Number four, senior left fielder Braden Malone.
Next up for the Farmers, left fielder Braden Malone grounded out to third base his first time up this evening. On deck for the Farmers, Caden Johnson. Cantu with his pitch. Quick look, comes set. There's the delivery. Ball one low. Cantu struggling to hit the strike zone here in the last couple innings. Malone ahead, two balls, no strikes. Ball in the dirt, gets behind the catcher, moves Irwin up to second base. And ladies and gentlemen, you'll have to apologize. We've got Mr. David Coleman in the press box, and that's his loud cackling half laugh that we don't have to listen to this year. So, but he comes up here every now and then to visit and poke fun. He's like a fun little mascot to have around. Got his farmer sweatshirt on, his farmer hat. Excuse me, Farmersville Junior High School. Three balls, no strikes to Malone. As that pass ball moved Irwin up to second, put him in scoring position for the Farmers. Here's a 3-0 pitch. Right down the pipe for three. Brings the count 3-1. Three balls, one strike. Cantu probably not wanting to put another guy on base. Going to give him a decent pitch. He does. Grounds it to shortstop. Checks third. Put out at first. Four out, number one. Look at that. Kind of a same thing as a sacrifice bunt. Moving that runner up to even better score position. Brings up number 22, Caden Johnson for the Farmers. KJ was hit by a pitch his first time up this evening. Took it right in the lower back. He was part of that scoring stretch there in the bottom of the second. First pitch to him is low and outside in the dirt, ball one. Caddo's playing the infield on the edge of the skirt, inward. Going to try to keep Irwin at third if a ground ball is hit. The catch to that is a bloop's going to be an infield single. No doubt score a run, so definitely a chance taken by the Foxes here. Trying to keep that lead to one as the Farmers were able to score four in the bottom of the second. One ball, one strike, one out. Here's a pitch from Cantu. Breaking pitch falls into the top of the zone. One ball, two strikes. Got one out here in the bottom of the third. Irwin at third base. Here's a 1-2 pitch. That's going to be over second base. Could be trouble. Right fielder's able to come in and make that play. Great job by the catcher to knock that down for out number two. Next up, number two, pitcher Caden Norman. Norman lined out to center his first time up this evening. Two outs. Irwin at third. Good try by the catcher to kind of glove that into the zone. You can get a little movement there as you cheat with the catcher, but not that much. One ball, no strikes, two outs. Run around the corner. Big looping breaking pitch stays outside as Norman showed a quick bunt there and drew that back. Two balls, no strikes. Cantu set, takes a quick peek to Irwin. Here's the pitch. Low gets Norman to a quick 3-0 count against Cantu. With the way he's struggling, I would put my bat on my shoulder because he still has to come back and throw you two perfect pitches. It's definitely a game of odds with baseball. Three balls, one strike to Norman. Cantu with an open base at first, but definitely does not want to put him on. Here's a 3-1 pitch. Norman fouls that off, brings the count three balls, two strikes. Number seven, Graves on deck for the Farmers. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. It's Cantu set. Here's a payoff pitch, line back up the middle. Great job by Norman, able to score the run as that throw from shortstop pulls the first baseman off the bag for another run.
Number seven.
Next up for the Farmers.
Baseman Paxton Graves.
Next up for the Farmers, number seven. Paxton Graves, runner on first. After Norman gets an infield single to score that run. Two outs here in the bottom of the third. Big swing and a miss by Graves. Misses strike one. Ball inside, evens the count, one ball, one strike, gets behind the catcher, moves Norman up to second base for a possible another scoring situation for the Farmers. One ball, one strike. Cantu set. Here's a 1-1 pitch. Graves chop fouls that one behind the catcher. One ball, two strikes. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Irwin is at second. Here's a 1-2 pitch. Strike three on Graves as he watches pitch go by. Leaves runner in scoring position there at second base, but not before you're able to get One run there in the bottom of the third. Quick score update. Your Lady Farmers trail the Community Braves. Lady Braves 2-1 in the fifth. We'll be back here in just a moment for the top of the fourth. Stay tuned. We're back here in the top of the fourth as your Farmers are able to put up another run in the bottom of the third, extend their lead 5-3 against the Foxes. Leading off for the Foxes is number three left fielder Wade Bowen. He grounded out to second, his first time up this evening. Bunts that one foul to the right side, strike number one. Here's the 0-1 pitch from Norman. Just misses outside, evens the count, one ball, one strike. Here's a 1-1 count. One ball, two strikes as Bowen fouls that one over the first base dugout. Here's a 1-2 pitch. Up and out, check swing. Gray appealed to first base. He didn't care to give his thoughts, so we're going to leave it at two balls, two strikes. Just misses inside low for ball three. Brings the count full on Bowen. Soft grounder hit to Fuller at shortstop. Quick throw over to first to Irwin for out number one.
Number 22, pitcher, Cesar Cantu.
Next up for the Foxes, pitcher number 22, Cantu. He struck out looking his first time up this evening. See if we can follow it up with another one. So far, that's the only strikeout for Norman this evening. See if he can add to those numbers here. One out in the bottom, top of the fourth. Good way to start. First pitch in there, looking for strike one. Here's the 0-1 pitch from Norman. Inside, evens the count. One ball, one strike. One pitch. Fouls that one straight back to the net. Brings the count one ball, two strikes. Here's a 1-2 pitch from Norman. Gets him looking again on the corner for strike three. Second out here in the top of the fourth. Next up, number 13, Cason Crane, the DH for the Foxes. He walked his first time up this evening. Fox is just now getting to the bottom order. Through 3 2/3. First pitch in there in the dirt, ball one. 2 outs, nobody on here in the top of the fourth. Not sure that miss looked like it caught the inside corner, but just catches the up and outside corner. 2 balls, 1 strike. He does like the outside corner. He does not like the inside corner. 3 balls, 1 strike on Crane. Possibly looking for another walk from Crane here. That's what he got his first time up this evening. And that's exactly what he was looking for, and he got it. Next up, number 11, the first baseman, Candell.
Number 11, first baseman, Sean Condell.
I appreciate it. 2 outs, runner at first. Should see a conservative lead there from Crane. Lefty pitcher. That ball just a bit outside. Gray able to lean out there and snag that.
I'm sorry. I can't even speak. Don't make fun of me.
Green takes a quick walk out to the mound to talk to Norman, just kind of settle his nerves maybe a little bit. You know, when they go out there to talk, they don't talk about baseball. They don't talk about pitches. They talk about where they're going to go fishing, what they're going to go eat after the game. Just something to get your mind off of it. Sometimes the more you think, the more trouble you get yourself into. So after the timeout, 1 ball, no strikes, 2 outs, runner on first. Here's a 1-0 pitch. Great job by Graves. He takes a leap on that line drive. Able to get the third out, leave a runner stranded. So after 3.5, your Farmers lead 5-3. We'll be back here in just a moment for the bottom half of the fourth. Stay tuned. Welcome back here to Farmers Baseball in the bottom of the fourth. Your Farmers are leading 5-3.
Junior center fielder, Zahir Venegas.
Leading off here in the bottom of the fourth, number 15, center fielder, Zahir Venegas. Landon Dunham came in his first time up for a quick pinch hit and struck out there. Zahir back in the place in the nine spot. First pitch in there in the dirt, ball one. On deck, back to the top of the order will be Brady Gray. Two balls, no strikes on Venegas. Cantu still on the mound for the Foxes. Low in the dirt, outside, ball three. Three balls, no strikes. Four-pitch walk there to Venegas to lead off the bottom of the fourth with a base runner. Back to the top of the lineup for the Farmers, leading off number 30. Brady Gray, but not before the Caddo Foxes head coach is going to take a quick timeout. Possibly could see a pitch and change here. We'll see here in just a few seconds. I have been known to be wrong a couple times. This might be one of them. Quick update on the Lady Farmer softball. They are trailing the community Lady Braves 4-1 in the top of the sixth. I stand corrected. I was right. I told you I was only wrong a few times. Going to be a pitch and change for the Foxes. Cato's going to move number one, Bobby Barrow, the second baseman, into the pitching spot. See if they put Cantu at second in his spot. I think that is going to be the situation here. So we'll give Barrow a few moments to warm up. We'll be back here in just a moment. After that pitch and change, we're back. Back to the top of the order also for the Farmers. Number 30, Brady Gray, the catcher. Started off the offensive charge for the Farmers back in the bottom of the second. Right fielder remembers that so he took a few steps back to the wall. First pitch in there for strike one. To Brady Gray. He had a two-run single. Back in the bottom of the second. Outside pitch, evens account, one ball, one strike. Barrow comes set. In the stretch, here's a 1-1 pitch. Catcher tried to bring that breaking pitch in there. Just wasn't going to get the umpire's call on that one. Two balls, one strike. Beautiful scenario here for a home run to right field. Wind's dying down. Absolutely not a strike. Two balls, two strikes. I try to keep it politically correct up here and not be a fan. I try to be a broadcaster. I try really hard. Two balls, two strikes. Venegas on first. Barrow takes a quick peek over his shoulder. He comes set. Here is a 2-2 pitch. Hard line drive to the right side. will definitely move Venegas up to third. Norton's going to hold him as Brady moves up there for a double. Great job by Brady Gray.
Number one, senior shortstop.
Sitting on that pitch and driving it to the right field. Another back half to that offensive charge in the second. Charge in the second. Jordan Fuller, who had a two-run double. Perfect scenario here for the same opportunity. With no outs. First two Farmer batters on second and third. Cantu will be responsible for the runner on third. First pitch in there, looking for strike one. Here's a pitch. Up and out, evens the count, one ball, one strike. That might be a strike on a couple taller players, but Fuller's got the strikes on the side of a cereal box. One ball, one strike. That ball's low and outside. Brings the count, two balls, one strike on Fuller. Burrell's looking to get his sign and comes set finally. Fuller's going to call time in the box. Burrell took a little bit longer shaking off the signs. He's quick set now. Here's a pitch. In the dirt, three balls, one strike. Fuller has the green light looking for a perfect pitch down the middle here. I don't think Caddo wants to load up the bases, even though they do have a open bag, but you've got the hot hitting Colin Berry on deck for the Farmers. I had to turn the volume down on that one, but he did call that pitch low and outside a strike. Full count to Fuller. There's ball five, excuse me, ball four, as that loads the bases for the Farmers. Brings up Colin Berry, hitting a respectable 4-11 on the season with the bases loaded, no outs. This should be a mindset that Collins wants to destroy this baseball. Not being able to be on the field defensively for the Farmers, which I know he misses. Barrow's set, bases loaded. Got his pitch. Hard barrel hit there by Berry, first baseman. Able to snag that out of the air to probably save definitely two runs, possibly three. One out for the Foxes. Here in the bottom of the fourth. Base is still loaded. Brings up number 14, Mason Irwin. Irwin walked his last time up this evening. Inconsistent as Texas weather. The strike zone of this umpire. One ball, no strikes. Two balls, no strikes to Irwin. Bases loaded. One out here in the bottom of the fourth. Here's a 2-0 pitch. Misses way outside, brings a count, three balls, no strikes. With the way Barrel's not being able to sit into the strike zone, a walk would be just fine here. That ball misses outside. Ball four. It's going to walk in a run for the Farmers. Brings up number four, left fielder. Braden Malone grounded out to shortstop. Malone. His last time up. Scoring update on your Lady Farmers. Top of the sixth, they are still batting two outs. Runners on second and third. They are trailing 4-2 against the Lady Braves. Big swing and a miss. Strike one to Malone. Bases are now loaded. Farmers and Lady Farmers. Breaking pitch sails outside, evens account, one ball, one strike on Malone. Bella Holland is at the plate for the Lady Farmers with bases loaded. As hot as she's been this season on the batting, there's nobody else I'd rather have there. Pitch in the dirt to Malone. Two balls, one strike. Malone skies out with foul. Live to fight another day as that foul ball falls. Two balls, two strikes. Two, two, one out. Bases loaded. Skies out to right field. That's going to be in foul territory. Right fielder is going to make an attempt. Still two balls, two strikes all Malone. Fighting off a couple foul balls there. Bases loaded, one out. Your Farmers lead 6-3 here in the bottom of the fourth. Malone just a little bit late on those pitches. Fouls that one off to the right side bullpen. Still 2-2. Barrow's set. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Low and outside in the dirt. Brings the count full. Bella Holland drew a walk. Scores a run, 4-3 in the top of the sixth for the Lady Farmers. Here's a full count pitch. Up and out of the zone for ball four. That's going to bring in another run as Brady comes in on the walk.
22, senior third baseman, Caden Johnson.
Next up for the Farmers, Caden Johnson. First pitch to Caden Johnson, fouled off to the right side. Ball's behind quickly, 0-1. Base is still loaded after back-to-back walks by Barrow. Pitch up and away, evens the count, one ball, one strike. Here's a 1-1 pitch from Barrow. KJ skies that. To the shortstop, he makes a play behind second base for out number two.
Working on a weekend like usual. Number two, well, senior pitcher, Caden Norman. Sweaty past us, they doing too much.
Going into the bottom of the sixth, your Lady Farmers able to put up a couple runs, cutting the lead 4-3 as they still trail the Lady Braves. Two outs brings up Caden Norman. Had an RBI single his last time up. Past the shortstop. First pitch down the middle looking. Strike one.
Come on, Judy, swing the bat.
No balls, two strikes as Norman falls behind quickly 0-2. Two outs, bases loaded here in the bottom of the fourth. Here's the 0-2 pitch to Norman. Fastball up and away. Here's a 1-2 pitch. Norman stays alive as he foul tips that. Norman fouls that one straight back to the screen, staying alive. Still one ball, two strikes. Barrow came in relief in this inning and has already thrown 32 pitches. Bases are still loaded, two outs. 1-2 count on Norman. Barrow's set to deliver. Here's a pitch. Just a bit outside. Evens the count, two balls, two strikes. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Caught the outside corner looking, strike three. But not before your Farmers able to get two more runs to pad that lead 7-3 through four. We'll be back here in just a moment for the top of the fifth. We're back here at Farmer Stadium in the top of the fifth. Your Farmers able to put up two more runs in the bottom of the fourth to extend their lead 7-3. Back to the top of the lineup, leading off number one, now the pitcher, Bobby Barrow, for the Caddo Foxes. He takes first pitch and lines that straight to center field. Jahir Venegas with an absolute awesome play as he stretches completely out for a diving catch in center field. You want to talk about giving the pitcher confidence? Make a play like that. Great job by Venegas. Great speed out there. Closed on it. Made a perfect play. Absolute awesome play by Venegas. Quick out there for the Farmers. First pitch to Robinson, the catcher there. Low for ball one. That pitch evens the count. One ball, one strike because he fouls it straight back to the backstop. Just misses outside. Two balls, one strike. Blown inside on top of the shoelaces of Robinson. Brings a count, three balls, one strike. Robinson flew out to right field his last time up. As he skies that one to the right side. Going to be out of play. Brings a count full. Three balls, two strikes, one out. Here's a full count pitch from Norman. Skies that to center field. Venegas tracking. Makes a play over his head as he's running to the wall just before the warning track for out number two. Venegas is earning his time tonight. Two great back-to-back plays by Venegas. Brings up number 10, center fielder, Luke Douglas. Luke Douglas scored the only runs for the Foxes tonight on a three-run shot in the first inning. But since then, Norman's pitch lights out. The defense has locked it down to keep them scoreless. First pitch outside, ball one. Just missing a little higher there. Brings a count, two balls, no strikes. Luke grounded to a third base. Ground out last time up. Quickly ahead, 3-0. Three balls, one strike there as that ball catches the outside corner on Douglas. Norman shifted a little bit on the rubber, see if he can work that pitch in a little bit. And he does. She hits sharply to shortstop. Fuller with an easy play. Makes it look easy for a quick three up, three down for your Farmers. Three up, three down. We'll be back in just a moment for the bottom half of the fifth. We're back here in the bottom of the fifth. Four shutout innings for Caden Norman and the Farmer defense. As Garrett Manese pinch hits for Paxton Graves. First pitch in there, swing and a miss for strike one. Evens count. One ball, one strike with that pitch low and outside. Two balls, one strike on McNeese. Two balls, two strikes is Evens' account on that outside pitch looking. Breaking pitch a little high, brings the count full. Three balls, two strikes. There's a payoff pitch from Barrow. Manese skies that to right field. Can of corn for the right fielder. For out number one.
Number 15, junior center fielder, Jahir Vanegas.
Number 15 next up for the Farmers. Jahir Vanegas, who made two outstanding plays in the top half of the fifth in center field. Plays like that definitely make it easier for a pitcher to pitch. First pitch in there, big swing, strike one for Vanegas. Strike two down the middle looking. Falls behind quickly 0-2 with one out, nobody on. Here in the bottom half of the fifth. Great hard shot by Vanegas. Definitely a single. He's looking to push it to second. He's in there with an absolute horrific slide. More of like a Vietnam tuck and roll, but he is in there safe for a double. Great way to start off his at bat here in the bottom half of the fifth. Umpire is going to give him a few minutes to walk it off. Rolled over that arm a few times. Back to the top of the lineup for the Farmers. Brings up catcher number 30, Brady Gray, who's been on fire tonight. Two-run single in the second, followed it up with a double in right field in the fourth. Part of that two-run scoring inning. One out. Vanegas at second off that hustling double. Up and out, first pitch to Gray was ball one. Gray looking for an opportunity here to trade places with Vanegas. Add a few more runs to that lead. Hard line drive to center field. Douglas makes the catch. Vanegas back to tag. Up with ease. At third is Vanegas. Gray able to move him up with a sacrifice fly. Brings up number one, Jordan Fuller.
Number one, senior shortstop, Jordan Fuller.
First pitch in there to Fuller, catches the outside corner. Strike one. Ball low and outside, evens the count. One ball, one strike on Fuller. Vanegas at third. Moved up on that sack fly to center field by Gray. Barrow gets a sign and comes set. Time by Fuller's. It took a little bit longer than he liked to get set. Here's a 1-1 pitch. Liner to second base. Going to be an easy play and the third out of the inning. Runner left on. No score through five. Your Farmers lead 7-3. We'll be back here in the top of the sixth in just a moment. Welcome back here to the top of the sixth, Farmers Baseball here at Farmer Stadium against the visiting Caddo Foxes. Leading off here in the top of the sixth, third baseman number 8, Talon McIntosh. First pitch in there, catches the corner, strike one. A little bit low and outside, evens count. 1-1 on McIntosh. One ball, 2 strikes as Norman's able to jump ahead on that strike pitch. Respectively, it's 79 pitches into the sixth. Line drive just over the head of the second baseman. Lands right in front of the center fielder. For a leadoff single by McIntosh. Going to bring up shortstop number 4, Tyler Wilson, for the Foxes. Wilson flew out to center his last time up this evening. Shows bunt. Lays a beautiful bunt down the first base line. Norman picks it up, throws it just past the running number 4. Irwin able to snag that for out number 1. Great job by Norman by staying under control and getting that ball, but still making a quick, effective throw to Irwin around the batter because he was moving towards the third base line. So great job by Norman. That run at second base doesn't matter at this point. Next up, number 3, left fielder Wade Bowen. Grounded out to shortstop his last time up. Up and away for ball 1 on Bowen. One out, runner at second in the top of the sixth. Here's the 1-0 pitch. In there for strike 1, evens account. 1-1 on Bowen.
That was good.
Here's a 1-1 pitch.
I could appreciate a good one.
Up and out. 2 balls, 1 strike. Three balls, one strike, a little high on Bowen. About the same size as Jordan Fuller, so there's that zero box strike zone again.
I'm not even on that list yet. I just wanted to say that. Eileen's the only exception. Eileen. The song.
Bowen fouls that low outside pitch off for strike two. Brings the count full. Scoring update on your Lady Farmers. They fell 4-3 to the Lady Braves of Community. Still secure in a playoff spot. Called strike three on the low strike there. Quick two outs. Brings up the starting catcher for the Foxes, number 22, Cantu, who moved to second base after the pitching change in the fourth. Runner at second. Two outs. Here's the first pitch to Cantu. He shuffles his feet and swings a miss. Strike number one. Quick look back at second at the runner. Fastball fouled straight back to the net. As Norman jumps ahead quickly, 0-2. Norman gets a sign, comes set, checks the runner at second. Here's the 0-2 pitch to Cantu. Just sails away. Brady's able to pop up and grab that ball. Keep a runner at second base for moving up to third. No harm there. 1 ball, 2 strikes.
Guys, guess what? You know I have my driver's license.
Line drive to center. Bray Malone coming in from left field, making a diving play out there as he hits the ground, just pops out of his glove. Run does score from second for Caddo as they were running with two outs. Puts Cantu at first base. Crane next up for the Foxes. 2 walks in a row tonight. Not sure if he's even swung his bat. But he has been on base twice. First pitch in there for ball one. That swing and a miss evens the count. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Here's a 1-1 pitch. Misses high. 2 balls, 1 strike. Quick timeout by Brady there to go out and chat with Norman real quick. 2 balls, 1 strike with a runner on first, 2 outs here in the top of the sixth. Your Farmers lead 7-4. Here's a 2-1 pitch. In the dirt, 3-1.
Wait,
That is the third walk in a row by Crane. His on-base percentage is 1,000. Getting on base is half the game. Somebody behind you can drive you in. Coach Nord's going to take a quick time out here to chit-chat with his infield. Pinch runner's going to come in for Crane. Be number two, the right fielder, Cameron Chase. Next up for the Foxes, number 11, Candell. Runners on first and second, two outs. Here's the first pitch. That was just called a strike a couple batters ago, but that's going to be a ball this batter. One ball, no strikes. Swing and a miss. Candell evens a strike. Evens a count. One ball, one strike. Outside pitch. Swing and a miss. Norman jumps ahead. One ball, two strikes on Candell. One ball, two strikes. Here's a pitch. Line to right center. Just off the end of Venegas' glove. Irwin's going to cut that throw. So run does come around to score for the Foxes. Moves that runner up to third. Norton probably going to make a pitching move here. We've got runners on the corners with two outs. We'll be back here in just a moment after the pitching change. Stay tuned. We're back here after the pitching change. Caden Norman, 100 pitches through the game. responsible for the runners on first and second. Two Ks on the evening. Five runs. Brings up number one.
Number one, pitcher Bobby Barrow.
Bobby Barrow for the Foxes. Mason Irwin in to pitch for the Farmers. Two outs as Norman traded spots with him at first base. First pitch in there just out of the strike zone. Little high ball one. Breaking pitch just doesn't break into the zone. Two balls, no strikes quickly on Barrow. That 2-0 pitch gets in there as Barrow steps back and swings, brings a count two balls, one strike with two outs. Irwin's set. Here's a 2-1 pitch. Barrow fouls that one straight back over the backstop. 2-2. As Barrow has to walk 15 feet out of the batter's box after that foul. Now he's back in there set. Two balls, two strikes. And then he's going to call time. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Full count on Barrow. Here's a 3-2 count. Just up. Ball four. Loads of bases for the Foxes with two outs.
Number five, catcher, Ryder Robinson.
Next up is going to be the catcher, number five, Robinson. Everyone gets a sign and comes set. First pitch in there for ball one. Curveball in there, catches the corner. One ball, one strike. Here's a 1-1 pitch. Fouled off of Robinson. One ball, two strikes. Bases loaded, two outs. As Irwin comes set for the 1-2 pitch.
What's wrong with that?
I don't have anything to say. Two balls, two strikes. Grounder hit to the third base side. KJ makes an easy play to Graves at second base for out number three. But not before Caddo is able to cut the lead by two runs, 7-5 through five and a half. We'll be back here in just a moment for the bottom half of the sixth.
Thank you.
clutching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you.
We're back here at Farmer Stadium, leading off for the Farmers in the bottom of the sixth. Number five, DH Colin Berry. Lined out hard to the first baseman his last time up while we had bases loaded. First pitch low and outside. Wasn't sure if he was going to call that a strike or not, so I had to wait. Second pitch in there high for ball two. Here's a 2-0 pitch. Berry fouls that one straight back to us in the net. Two balls, one strike. Here's a 2-1 delivery. Low and outside. Ball three. Three balls, one strike. He waited on the batter. Three balls, two strikes on that low pitch to Berry. Full count on Berry. Barrow comes set. Here's a pitch. There's ball four.
Number 14, junior first baseman, Mason Irwin.
Next up for the Farmers, pitcher number 14, Mason Irwin. Had an RBI walk his last time up. That fourth inning when we put up a two spot. Up and in for ball number one on Irwin. Irwin showed bunt there, unable to make connection. Evens the count, one ball, one strike. Berry on first after that leadoff walk. Here at the bottom of the sixth, Sure Farmers lead the Foxes 7-5. Quick throw over there to Berry to keep him honest. Another quick throw over there to first. Still one ball, one strike on Irwin. Swing and a miss. One ball, two strikes. Barrow really concerned with Colin over there at first base. Definitely low and outside. Anybody that knows baseball can tell that. Two balls, two strikes to Irwin. Still giving Barry a look over there at first. He's thrown as many balls over there as he has to Irwin. Irwin pops that up to second base side. Out number one. As Cantu makes that squeeze just off the grass, it's second base. Next up, number four, left fielder Braden Malone. One out, runner on first. KJ on deck for the Farmers. Barry definitely having fun with the pitcher over there. Barrow no more gets the ball back from first baseman, and he's already got a 10-foot lead. Barrow with a little bit of a grin on his face as he throws that. Malone with a grounder through the left side, moves Barry up to second base, brings up Caden Johnson.
Number 22, senior third baseman.
Runners on first and second. KJ takes that first pitch and fouls it straight back to the net. Pitch in the dirt for ball one. Good stop by Robinson. Keep the runners at first and second. Caden Norman on deck for the Farmers. Barrow set. Here's a 1-1 pitch. In there for strike two. Catches the low part of the zone. One ball, two strikes on Caden Johnson. Low and outside in the dirt, two balls, two strikes. Two pitches outside in the dirt, brings the count full on Johnson. Barrow set. Here's a 3-2 pitch. Called strike three.
Number two.
Two down here in the bottom of the sixth. Brings up number two, first baseman Caden Norman.
Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts. Caught me slipping once, okay, so what? Someone hit your block up, I tell you.
Barry jumping around in second, trying to get in the Barrow's head. Pitch low in there for strike one. Norman set on that breaking pitch, just pokes it foul to the left side, evens the count. 0-2. There's the 0-2 pitch to Norman. Swing and a miss, strike three. Two runners on, two runners left. Going to the top of the seventh. Farmers hold them here to secure the W. We'll be back here in just a moment for the top of the seventh. Here we are back in the top of the seventh. It's your Farmers lead, 7-5, brings up number 10, Luke Douglas, the center fielder for Caddo. Farmers need 3 outs here to secure the win. Keep their playoff hopes alive. Douglas grounded out to shortstop his last time up. On deck is number 8, McIntosh for the Foxes. 3-4-5 batting here in this inning. Just inside, 2-1 on that breaking pitch. Ground ball hit sharply past the second base for a leadoff single here in the top of the seventh. Brings up McIntosh, number 8.
Alan McIntosh.
Douglas at first, McIntosh in the box for the Foxes. Good first pitch strike there by Irwin. Like to see a double play here. Irwin jumps ahead quickly, 0-2 on McIntosh. No balls, 2 strikes. No outs, runner on first. Break a pitch, didn't break. Stayed high and outside. One ball, two strikes. Outside, two balls, two strikes, evens the count. Fouls that one straight back to the net. Still remains 2-2. Breaking pitch hung outside. Brings the count 3-2 on McIntosh. Douglas is at first. Looks like Nord's going to talk to the umpire there to see if there was any interference there on the into third or into second, excuse me. After that umpire discussion, we're back. Well, check that. Norden trying to finalize a couple things with the infield umpire. I think the discussion was interference at second base would obviously cause first base runner to be automatically out as Graves received the ball from Fuller going to make that turn. Runner from first base into second. Slid and popped up into Graves. Umpire is going to continue the discussion real quick.
What were you reading in seventh grade?
One out on the double play attempt there. Moves the runner up to second. He is going to remain. Shortstop Tyler Wilson in there. Swings at a first pitch and misses for strike one. Outside pitch, evens account, one ball, one strike. Wilson just tucked out of the way on that up and in. Two balls, one strike. Big swing and a miss, evens account, two balls, two strikes, one out. Wilson fouls that one right back to the net. Still remains two balls, two strikes. Breaking pitch misses. Three balls, two strikes. On Wilson, one out, runner at second. Here in the top half of the seventh. Here's a 3-2 pitch.
Three! Strike three! Come on!
He didn't give us that call.
Number three, left fielder.
Runners at first, at second. Norton's going to take a timeout. Quick pitch and change here for the Farmers. Looks like it's going to be shortstop Jordan Fuller moving to the pitching spot. Moving Graves to shortstop. Possibly Carlo to second. Mason to outfield, bringing in Jacob Watkins. We'll let Jordan Fuller warm up a few moments. We'll be back here in just a few. After the quick pitch and change, we're back. Runners on first and second. Jordan Fuller is going to be on the mound now for the Farmers. Brings up number three, left fielder Wade Bowen. First pitch from Fuller misses inside for ball one. If you need a double play, would be nice right here. This is outside. Two balls, no strikes on Bowen. Fuller behind quickly, 3-0.
22. Second base, Cesar Cantu.
Bases loaded, runners on first, second, third. Kind of stepped over myself there. First pitch in there to Cantu for the Foxes. Ball one outside. One out, top of the seventh. Strike down the middle, evens the count. One ball, one strike on Cantu. Here's a 1-1 pitch. One ball, two strikes. Fuller shakes off a sign, gets what he likes, comes set. Quick peek to second. Here's a pitch. Breaking pitch just a little out of the zone. Two balls, two strikes. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Got him fisted. Strike three. Two outs.
Come on. Let's get it right here. Can call him the call of the strike? He looks wrong. Number two, right fielder, Cameron Chase.
Number two, Cameron Chase. Into bat for the Foxes. First pitch in there catches the outside corner for strike one. Pitch in there for strike. One ball, two strikes. Not sure what the umpire was waiting on right there. That was the best pitch Jordan's thrown in his 12 pitches. That's unfortunate that high school pitcher in 4A baseball can't get that call. Wow. We're going to try this again. Two balls, two strikes. Fouls that one off.
What is he saying?
Catcher interference, it looks like. That miss called strike three by the umpire just cost us a run. Number 11, Candell takes first pitch in there, swinging strike one. Two outs, bases loaded. That's the same pitch that he missed for strike three just a moment ago. As Candell falls behind quickly. 0-2.
Three!
That one's inside. One ball, two strikes. Well, that's your game, folks. Not quite the way we wanted it to end. We did get the W. But Farmers fought through offensively a lot better this evening than we were the other evening at Caddo. So Farmers take the W. Move to 5-3 in district. We will be back here tomorrow. Another home game Friday night, 7 p.m. against Sanger, non-district game. Hope to see you guys tuned in. We appreciate you tuning in this evening, and we'll be back next time. Thank you.